So the American title of the book is The Mistress's Daughter. And it is the story of my finding out that my biological family was looking for me. I grew up knowing I was adopted. I was adopted as an infant. When I was in my 30s, my biological mother got in contact and said she wanted to meet with me. And it was a very, very difficult experience. I wasn't expecting to meet my biological family. And it was interesting to me as a writer how much it undid my sense of identity. I always thought of myself as sort of a solid person, and I built an identity. And I realized that an identity is a narrative. An identity is a narrative, a story that you tell yourself or your family tells you. We are these people. We are from this place. This is what we believe in. And we usually buy into that identity. So to have someone come along and say, it turns out that's not really who you are, you're this other person, was very interesting to me, both as a writer and as a young woman. And so I wrote The Mistress's Daughter about learning about my biological family, and then half of the book is about research that I did to try to learn more about relatives and different parts of that experience. And I would say it was a very, very difficult book to write. I don't usually write autobiographically. I found it like sort of like picking at a wound and asking myself, does this hurt? How much does this hurt? But I was very, in the end, proud to have written it, because I think there are many people who have either an experience of being adopted or someone they know is adopted. And it's hard to find language sometimes for emotional experience. And I think I used my skills as a writer to begin to articulate what that was like. And a lot of people have written to me and said how much it meant to them. So that is something I'm happy about.